It's a blessing to hear all this music, isn't it? Pretty nice. Well, as some of you may know, one of the bands that was scheduled to appear today was the Allman Brothers. But fortunately and unfortunately, Greg Allman came upon a situation where he was able to get an emergency operation and have a liver transplant 3 days ago, and he's doing well in Jacksonville, Florida, and he's going to be here the next time, he says. But I'm wondering if we all screamed really, really loud, really, really loud for Greg Allman, gave it a real roar, we could make him better real fast. Can we hear a big roar for Greg Allman? A big roar for Greg Allman! A big roar for Greg Allman! But we are fortunate enough to have some great players from the Allman Band. The miracle of the Derek Trucks Susan Tedeschi Band has taken their place. It's a miracle! It's a God-blessed miracle! Featuring Warren Haynes. Ladies and gentlemen, the Derek Trucks Susan Tedeschi Band. Let's hear it for them. Knock them out, Derek. Knock them dead.
the subway's closing down. Gonna carry this dream to the other side of town. Walk that line, tall and firm. Gotta spend your whole life trying. Ride that train and free your heart. It's midnight up in Harlem.
Warren Haynes on guitar and vocals.
That last song was written by Mike Madison on the vocals back there with Ryan Shaw back there, hanging out. Mike Madison wrote that. It's called Midnight in Harlem. This next one's an old Delaney and Bonnie tune. And we were very excited to play some of their music.
You know, so in Delaney and Bonnie, it was one of the first ones I was like, wow, who's that? And wow, that is really cool. And it reminded me of Eric Clapton, and it reminded me of like Leon Russell and certain people. But I didn't realize how connected all of them were until even recently, where I was really freaked out by the whole Tulsa, Oklahoma connection with J.J. Cale, and then everybody like Leon Russell, Carl Radle, bass player, that played with Mad Dogs and Englishmen, also played with Derek and the Dominoes.
I think Delaney and Bonnie, Mad Dogs and Englishmen, it's almost, people are coming around to it. It's, I grew up listening to music of that era. I didn't know Mad Dogs and Englishmen until a handful of years ago, you know, and I heard it. So how did I miss that? Some great stuff. And in some ways, I think that concept wasn't fully realized. I think it, maybe because of the personalities and because of the habits of the days, it was hard to contain, and maybe the maturity hadn't caught up with the concept. So in a way, I almost feel like a band like this is kind of trying to pick up where that left off, you know?
Coming home, coming home. comes too long. I want you so bad, I can hardly stand it. I'm so tired and I'm all alone. We'll soon be together, and maybe that's why I'm coming home. Your love. Hitchhiking on the turnpike all day long. Nobody seemed to notice. It just passed me on by. To keep from going crazy, I got to sing my song. Takes a whole lot of loving, and you know that's why I'm coming home.
Can't find the light. to guide you through a cloudy day. When the stars ain't shining bright and it feels like you've lost your way. When the candlelights of home burn so very far away. Oh, you got to let your soul shine, just like my daddy used to say a soul shine. It's better than sunshine, it's better than moonshine, damn sure better than rain. Yeah, now people don't mind, we all feel this way sometimes. Got to let your soul shine, shine till the break of day. I grew up thinking I had it made, make it on my own. But life can take the strongest man and make him feel so alone. Now sometimes I feel a cold wind blowing through my aching bones. I think back to what my daddy said. He said, boy, in this darkness, before the dawn, let your soul shine. Sunshine. Better than sunshine. Sunshine. Better than moonshine. Damn sure better than rain. Yeah, now people don't mind. We all feel this way sometimes. Got to let your soul shine. Shine till the break of day. Sometimes a man can feel this emptiness, like a woman has robbed him of his very soul. A woman too, God knows she can feel like this. Well, hey, when your little world seems cold, you got to let your spirit take control.
Thank you so much. Please welcome Dave and Caesar from Los Lobos.
Thank you so much. Thank you. No longer.
David Hidalgo, Cesar Royce.
Please welcome to the stage Mr. Chris Staton. Everybody, you're going to see him a little later, but he's going to play this next song with us because he played on the original with Leon Russell and Joe Cocker and Mad Dogs and Englishmen.
Yeah.
You're never going to believe what I just saw. I saw a complete Tool bag dressed up as Elvis Presley, you know, the wig and the whole thing and talking like him. It's like, get a life, pal. You know what I'm saying? Really. Couldn't believe it. Well, we've gotten rid of a lot of the lousy bands. They've played and they're done. They're already on the bus. We got rid of all them. The good stuff's starting to show up right now. We're going to play some blues for you this time, featuring one of my favorite guitar players, Mr. Johnny Lang. An imported guy from a band that I think broke up called the Rolling Stones by the name of Ronnie Wood. And fortunately for all of us, a local guy who's going to show him how to play, Mr. Buddy Guy. Buddy Guy, Johnny Lang, Ronnie Wood. Buddy Guy, Johnny Wood, Johnny Lang.
Five long years for one woman, and she had the nerve to kick me out.
Got a job in a steel mill, check it still looks like a slave. 5 long years every Friday I call. Stay home is on my head. If you ever been mistreated, then you know what I'm talking about. I'm a 5 long years for a woman. She had enough to put me out. Yeah.
I don't have to tell you who they are. Because it's a blast standing between two young men can play a guitar like this, man, you know. I don't know how you feel, but I feel like I'm in heaven. A lesson I should have known a long time ago. The next woman I marry, she got to get two jobs, and I want her to work and bring some dough. I've been mistreated, and you know that's what I'm talking about. Well, you know, I worked 5 long years for one woman, and she had the nerve, yes, and she had the nerve, oh, and she had the nerve, and she had to put me out.
But he says, oh, it's such an honor to play with you. And I'm going, you don't get it. And Hubert, he says, oh, it's such an honor to have you in the room, you know. And I'm going, no, it's my honor. But that's an ongoing thing. I mean, just saw James Burton. And, you know, everybody's got so much respect for each other. And I think that just overrides everything. And that respect just shines through and helps us all to have a great time.
Yeah. 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 Thank you.
sing. I know you know that song. Guitar string, I'm gonna keep on trying to play it, cause I will miss you. Get another guitar, gonna keep on playing, yeah, cause I don't miss you. No. Hey, hey, hey. Wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. Thank you so much for putting up with us, ladies and gentlemen. How about Mr. Ronnie Woods, huh? Mr. Johnny Lang, how about that, huh? Yeah. When I get into this kind of company, I wish I could play all night.
And the legend, Buddy Guy.
Thank you. day. Amazing. Really nice.
Cool.
So it's just waiting for us.
Where are we going, guys?
Jeff Beck. Jeff Beck. Jeff Beck.
La 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 la
Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you so much. Jason Robello, please show your appreciation. Rhonda Smith. Him. Narada Michael Warden. Thank you so much. Thank you.
He's changed his style a whole bunch of times, and he's always, I think he's just always gone with what was true. And sometimes that was fusion, and sometimes it was playing someone else's band, and sometimes the Rod Stewart stuff. He's living so many lifetimes in one.
Excuse me while I kiss the sky. It's been a very groovy day. It hasn't been a big, big ego scene. Just lots of musicians and talent showing their talent. No ego scene. The top bill, very, very groovy. Weeks. Bass, very groovy. Gad on drums, so groovy. Stanton on keyboards, a talent. My favorite keyboardist of all time, Winwood. And our host for this evening, the man who made this all possible. The man who asked me to come back here for Christmas. The man who asked us all to be here. The man who asked all this talent to come and give their talent to you. Clapton, very groovy. Clapton, very groovy. Ladies and gentlemen, Eric Clapton.
Are you sick of the sound of the electric guitar yet? And if it rains, do you care?
I think Clarence is just, I think he's got like a deep, deep pocket and a deep groove that it doesn't really exist in a lot of people in this day and age. You know, you don't see that kind of thing. I mean, he has like this self-confidence in what he does and his music, and he's so, so connected to what he does and believes in himself and his music so much that, I mean, he can get people standing up almost immediately when he starts to, when he just opens his mouth.
The hands are So we all ride with the same shit. So we all ride with the same shit. So we all ride with the same
Citizen Copley.
Eric is, I don't know, if anything, he's always turned me on to new people. Like today, even, he was saying, have you heard this guy? Have you heard this? You know, no, I haven't. And he was saying, well, listen, you know, come on, come with me and listen. And that's what I love about him. He always got his ear open.
Jeff Beck, please. Steve Winwood. Thank you.
To you and your seed, Lord knows you feel no pain. And after you and your seed, Lord knows you feel no pain. Same time right here. off of mine. Think you're losing your liquid garden, Arizona's new red sand. Oh, in liquid garden, Arizona's new red sand. From a frown and blue in California, we hold hands
There's terrible news. We're going to have to go extra innings. There's one more guy that needs to practice with you. Can you hang around for one more guy?
For one of my favorite albums, I have had B.B. King Live at the Regal. I've had that since I was, like, I don't know, 19 or so. It's a beautiful album. I think, in a way, it's what he doesn't play. I mean, his phrasing is absolutely stunning, you know, and it's effortless. It's really effortless. No, he doesn't even think about it. It just comes out. You know.
He's a wonderful guy, man. Not a wonderful musician. And he's old pro. He been out here for years, man. He know what it's all about. And he can play, and he can sing. Yeah?
You can blindfold me, man, and if you give me 10 guitar players, if BB hit a note, I can tell you it was him or not. Because I don't know what he does, man, but he just, and my dad told me before he passed away 43 years ago, say, son, if you're gonna play, play like BB, because he never makes a mistake hitting the strings. And you never, I do it sometimes, like I went to hit this note and missed it.
That's what makes the whole thing great, is that different people can have different spikes in their bar chart of what they're able to do, and then when they all come together on stage at Crossroad, that's what gives you the, you know, unbelievable feeling of watching that many guitar players.
Well, yeah, I mean, you can even feel the shift a little bit from the last Crossroads to this one. You can there's a real human element to seeing Hubert this time from last time, you know, just. He's still serving and it's still Hubert, but, you know, those years start adding up.
I can't hear you!
At that stage of the game. Same with BB, same with Johnny, and, you know, it's and then for the younger generation, you can see that some of the guys have maybe matured a shot. Some of the guys have gone off course a little bit. You know, there's real life involved here, you know, and there's all, you know, none of these stories, Dwayne, Hendrix, Clapton, Beck, none of them are just this perfectly elegantly written story. There's bumps in the road, and there's something great about seeing, it's like a family reunion to me, Crossroads. You see all these people that you know and respect and over the years become friends with, and it becomes closer and closer. But there's real life happening in between those 3 years.
Somebody's passed the torch to me, you know, and guys are looking up to me. You know, to be the next guitar innovator, music innovator person. And, you know, it's all great because it helps you, at least while we're still all alive, and even when we die, I think that's what we all care about. You know, I think guys like, you know, Clapton really, I mean, he's already said it to me anyway, so he really cares about what we're gonna do when 30 years from now, when he's not around, 40, you know what I'm saying? What's going to be going on? You know, are these guys, Robert Randolph, Derek Trucks, Jack White, you know, a lot of these guys, what are these guys going to be doing? What are we going to be doing?
There's a lot of mutual respect in the room, so it was easy. If it would have been another group of musicians trying to come together like that, it might have been a total train wreck, but, you know, everybody's on the same page, and there was no egos conflicted. It was just music, and everybody 2 hours before the set were rehearsing it, and we're like, you know, this is gonna be fine. Let's just go out there and, you know, just give it a shot. And it felt really good. It was some magical moments.
I think that having a knowledge of the history of music is such an important aspect. I mean, it's something that's really dying. Because, you know, with pop music, it doesn't really go back that far. You know, people's knowledge of what came before anything, that doesn't even exist. It's like, it's Green Day. What came before that? I don't know, because I'm listening to Green Day. And that's what I like.